三幸町駅まで行きます。三幸町
Thank you.
high jump in luminosity, and then go up to factor 5 to 10 to 7 higher luminosity, which allow to get 5,075 about 7 times alpha. And of course, I mean, as you know, this program that they discover, which will be discovered, is that there will be new data technology acquired, and so the program will naturally adapt to what we see, and so then this is our view of today. And so it's a certain dynamic program, and so this will be naturally adapted to what will be observed, to learn, to be needed. So this is a construction, and it becomes a machine, and you put that together, some plots, the values, there is a sense of events, we understand the model, it's a very long process, something that is done by the experimental, it's a very long process. Especially select your trigger in such a way in which you keep more of the regions where there are resonances of interest, but then you tend to suppress the data to keep it manageable. Still, when you do that, in VLC, it becomes a major player in the big data world. This is a talk I made for the chat conference last year. So this is a blog that I wanted to show to you. So this is the kind of data sets that we are dealing with. So the LC data is about 15 petabytes per year that is collected. This is basically comparable to the uploads of YouTube. This is much larger than the library of members. Knowledge that is stored. Should take all the current number of data sets, including the simulation, and everything that is stored. The number of petabytes is about as much as you have as the Google searches.
And the insect. That is one of the six candidates. So what the LC can do,
and going and looking for new particles, especially those which may be connected with dark matter, which will be interacting massive particles. And so, it's going to look at the production of those through whatever process originated by proton-proton collisions. So basically, in all the plots that I'm going to show, you see it inside this big blob, in the sense that that's where the interesting physics happens. So when you are looking at it, you see how this blob, whatever that happened here, you can check the you see out here, and you see the production of some particles, and you see these new particles eventually going into standard particles, the D-plus, something that escapes the detector. In the case of this idea, the production of the swarms, or the winos, and the in fields, you have already with the current data, this is not true, this is what we have already on tape, you have constraints which go up, typically, for mass scales of about the TV, for some of the processes you see here, the observer, you are going under 50 GV, and it goes up to a bit more than 1 TV here, under some conditions, and there are large parts of the paper space, which actually are less than code, but then you push them into the limits, there are already the capability to test up the sales of the TV scale. You ask yourself how this is going to evolve. In this case, it's a simulation of Luino production and SUSY, which is a large number of models, and this distribution is a Luino mass that comes out. The distribution here shows basically what is left untouched after the run one. So basically, anything above, a little bit below, above 900 GV, has been probed, mostly probed, what is above not. The run 2 plus 3, we probe essentially up to about 1.9 TV. So you notice that we probe beyond 2 TV to about 2.3, 2.4 TV. This is also shown in the experimental plot, with a projection from the experiment, shows something similar. I mean, currently here, you have your reach up to a bit above 1 TV, but with large holes, and then you're going up to 300 femtobarn, and then you go up, which is a line here, you go just a bit above 2 TV at the maximum, but I believe some regions are probed, and then you go essentially up to almost 3 TV, which is a large region. So you see that the music of energy at mass scale are, of course, at a larger trade-off, so you can push your sensitivity by using the music, so probably the daily part of distribution function, so it's very good, and it's different from the electron collider, the nano collider, actually, the music corresponds to an energy increase, an energy sensitivity increase. If you're looking to, for example, the scalar tops, the complexity of the light increases, there are more than the part of the final state here. You see again that if you have some coverage up to something like 600 GV, but with large holes, this is CMS, this is Atlas, which is a similar. It is interesting to look also to weak production, and this is a very strong production. Processes, you can have weak production of new particles, some intersection are correspondingly lower, but here you are now probing really in the core of the piece of the series, which may be connected to dark matter. These are the Ibrahim and Susie, one of the leading candidates of WIMP. So you see that you already have some sensitivity, which is significant. You see that basically you can reach out to something which is not far from the kind of limits that were for the standard collecting particles under some conditions, particularly probed up to 500 600 GV, for both experiments, 700 GV, and 3 KZ. When you'll be going to 300 femtobarn or 3000 femtobarn, you see that your reach will go basically close to 1 TV in all these cases. So see, also to show that it's not true that the photon machine is only good to see strongly interacting particles, it's very good to see also weak interacting particles, provided that your music is large enough that actually you can get some. And this is an exemplification of that. So you ask yourself, what's the relevance of this number? And then we return to the WIMP number paradigm, the leading amino acid of WIMP miracles of relates to the fact that if you have a weak interacting massive particle, the typical cross-section corresponding to weak processes, you get naturally the dark matter of the ray density measured by the cosmic microwave background, with a mass which is about 100 GV. However, when you look at a specific series, like for example in supersymmetry, you find that the situation is a bit different, this goes from the order of magnitude to detail. So you see here that this is 0.1 in ray density, corresponding to the Planck result, and this is obtained basically for different choices of the nature of the neutralino and of the neutralino sector mixing matrix, with anything that goes exactly between 100 GV, so that goes up to 3 TV. So there is in a well-defined series, where both particles can contribute to the mutilation processes, to the production processes, you have a very broad range of possibilities, and this is a corresponding result that you have for direct detection. So I think this is a probe that goes to 2 TV or even beyond, is extremely important, because this is within SUSY, the TV is a natural mass at which you may expect, and we impact to see that this is responsible for dark matter. You can also do something similar, but going with some abstraction from a well-defined series, do that in effective series. And so there, it's interesting because the machine can perform searches not only looking for a well-defined standard space which corresponds to a model which predicts production indicator of the particle, but even more in general. You may look again at your blob, again using this blob, and tell us the fact of the physics which happens inside here, but you don't tell if you don't know, you have effective theory inside the blob. And you look to the radiation of the gluon, the photon, WZ, something out of the incoming leg here, which is basically witnessing the fact that you have hard scattering processes. So you are looking for events in which you don't care what your dark matter production process is, but you're looking for events where there is nothing in the detector except something that tells that actually an interaction has taken place. So this is not done, that's something like that. So it's interesting because since you see that, then it can be estimated against the framework of models like SUSY or scientific series. So here, typically, you can interpret the results as the ratio of the mass scale, which is the mass scale of your theory, divided by some coupling constant. And you can relate the limit, which are typically put on these ratios, to the value of the scattering cross-section of this particle on nucleons, which is obtained by dark matter detection experiment, which is typically looking for the faint signal of the wind which scatters off a nucleon inside a large volume detector on the ground. And these are the scattering cross-section, depends again on your mass here and your matrix here. So this basically, we are looking exactly the same things, because the scattering process is on the same diagram here, but the same curve. There will be a lot of work with this field data. If you have such data, there was one in the lab of data, so you can tell you just a new object is a event, nothing else, and it's a striking one, you see. So there have been searches performed in the object, so single object produced, so via distributions, you see that new physics will show up in the far tail of the transverse energy associated with a single object. In here, this is the data. Nazis for the violence of the Mother Constitution. He could say he's a woman, and he was a front and said, Jake, that's a problem. For example, the processor, the DNA machine that is available to the people, that is able to some deficit in the data in the Alga, that is not from Intuna, he can do where he uses Z, for example, it's a boson that he could offer, and again, yeah, there is agreement while you expect that in all these cases, access is a bit too large, missing IT. But that's something that is happening now, and is going to continue to happen, so the basic of topology is dependent on where the model is, so the power of the probe. So this is, if you take a technical theory, this is one, was it going to be a operator, so just one, of some work, doing this number of friends, series friends. So you see here, so this is your mass, your theory, this is the mass of the WIMPA. So this is a region which is actually, it would be probed by 310 to 140 data, so it's a region down here excluded. You see this line here shows a region which is compatible, this is a density, that this is a funnel that goes in here, so this region will be probed, and this is a region that is probed by the direct detection data. So you see that if you put together all that, I mean the direct detection data, LC data, dark matter, direct detection, you can get, you can differentiate all the constraint, I mean, some of the region is parameter space. This is the same, we can now project the region sensitivity of the LC on the plot which shows the scattering cross-section for WIMP direct detection as a function for the mass of the WIMP itself. So you see that there is a very strong synergy between experiment that are looking for dark matter and the LC searches, which will be one of the highlights of the upcoming one, because those LC and the direct detection experiments would like significantly leap forward in sensitivity. You can also look to one object in context of a specific already high model, for example, and then we have that there that we will probe regions which are difficult for the direct searches, so you're probing the region of a large amount of genes, for example. So one object by large sensitivity is exactly where your direct detection becomes weaker. So again, one object can use in a high model to uncover some specific region of the free space. It's interesting that the actual space you can get using Numino searches LC is not only number, it says the number is 1 TV, it becomes 45, 2 TV, the larger the better. So that actually can be very interesting in a quantitative term. I mean, this is, for example, if you take in the context of gravitino dark matter, and you are going and look at the regions of the parameter space where you are plotting here the gravitino mass, the functions of the Numino mass, there are regions which are allowed, basically above these curves, depending on the rating temperature of the universe. Now it's interesting because of the rating temperature, the inflation, depends, has some tight constraint which come from cosmological bounds. And so, typically, you like the temperature to be quite large, let's say the order probably written to the 9 TV or so. And so, in case you don't observe any Numino, as you say, 14 TV and even more inside the LC, then you can fully exclude this region of the parameter space. So basically, you can exclude rating temperature in the rating parameter models, basically, that are the value best fitting is leptogenesis scenario. So you can bring in a breakdown supersymmetry and connect that with data on cosmology and try to either constrain some parameter because in some specific models, and this is one specific models, and then to obtain some exclusions of the data parameter space. So this is the value of machine as much as you can, so the other luminosity, your goal as a mass scale of new physics, some time to come and to recover some parameter space.
Which is a relation of the mass, 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 which is a relation of the
So we had a real fleet between that mass of the jet detected in generic measure. You don't measure the smart mass, you're measuring some kind of generic mass, PC mass. And so then, I mean, you have to relate that to the mass, which is relevant to your experimental calculation. So it's important to make this connection as reliable as possible. We have instructions how to extract the masses from the experimental data, which is basically genetics, that is available to the full profit of the top mass accuracy from the estimation that you have to interpret in the exact. What you measure typically is a product of production cross-section, as I mentioned, in the side of uncertainty times, regulation. You measure that you typically improve them and normalize the standard model prediction. You go to call the signal strength. One means a particle is exactly like the standard model, different from one. That is exciting. How much excitement is around? Then this is a number that are measured by the two experiments, DDBAR, TAU, and WZZ. There is another lineup of one. So it's the standard model Lipix, something similar for Atlas, so we need a bit of fluctuation of the DDBAR. about 20 kilometers from here, and it's down here in the ski resort. So you don't need to bring anything except, first of all, if you're not French or Swiss, because I need to have that visa authorization, and then you must have a warm clothing, because it's going to be very cold. But then you can actually rent the ski equipment. If you decide to go for snowshoeing, that's also an option. And the bus will leave on Wednesday afternoon at 1 p.m., which is just half an hour after the trip, so you have to be pretty quick. And the bus will be back with, we leave back from the resort at 5, meaning we'll be back here around 6, if everything goes to plan. And there are 50 seats on the bus, and I think from the listing which is here, there will be room for you.